Hi there. I've wanted to do a series of short videos just sort of exploring some of the basic features of Cinema 4D. So this is going to be the first one of those videos, and I'd like to look at an object called the Connect object. I think that's what it's called. It's here in the Generators menu. Yep, it's called Connect. And, well, for a long time I forgot that this object existed. I remembered when they first introduced it, but then I'd never used it ever again. Then I was looking at a Grayscale Gorilla tutorial. This is a Grayscale Gorilla website here. And I saw Nick use it in one of his tutorials, and I thought to myself, man, that's a really cool use for it. So I'm just going to highlight that really quickly. Again, this is something I saw Nick do. It's a really nice tip, but here we go. So I think that if you create MoGraph text, all right, so we create a little bit of Mo text and, you know, let's say connect, and let's use a nice round font. I guess Tahoma's okay. So we have this text, and then we add a bevel to the caps. So, you know, we say start cap, end cap. We now have sort of a fillet on the caps. Fillet. I've heard it actually pronounced both ways, fillet and fillet. Anyway, so now we have this nice cap, but we notice that the Phong shading still breaks. So it turns out the connect object can fix this. If you just put this in a connect object, it completely joins the Phong shading, so it's not broken anymore. Let me create a nice nice purple material so we can take a look at that actually happening. So if I color the Mo text purple and I color the connect object purple, the color won't change as I drop one into the other. So here we have areas where the caps, you know, because there are edges there, the caps don't do a smooth Phong transition, and the connect object, it welds all of the points. So the minute you drop it into the connect object, you kind of see some of those transitions disappear, and that can be really useful. You know, like I said, I saw Nick use it in one of his videos, and it was a really cool way to connect things. Now if you adjust the tolerance, you can actually get it to start to swallow itself whole, which is kind of a fun looking effect. Not really useful, but yeah, so this is a really cool way to sort of prep some text for an upcoming effect. And that's how Nick used it. But if we were to look at what the connect object does on a much more elementary level, let's take two completely separate objects. A plane. Let's look at wireframe view and give the plane maybe 5 segments by 5 segments. So we have a plane here. I'm going to look at it in wireframe view. And it's 5 segments by 5 segments. I'm going to give it a purple color. And you know what? Let's put it back to the world center. Scale it down a little bit. There we go. That looks good. So now let's create a... let's just create another plane. So we have two individual planes. We don't know why, but we do. We have two separate objects. And if we wanted to connect these, we'd have to morph them into one object somehow using a Boolean, or just connecting them using the connect object plus delete function. But if we were to put both of these in a connect object and then move one closer to the other, we should see at a certain point that they actually join. So if I increase the tolerance, you can see that we can move these objects close enough together to where they connect and become one object. Now, this is important, obviously, because of the example I just showed you with the Phong shading. If we were to move this object so that it snaps and it connects, right, we can actually see that the Phong shading transitions. There's no hard edge. There's a soft edge. So these are two completely separate objects, but they're being welded and treated as one, and that's a really cool feature. You know, the connect object is good if you're making a tire and you're modeling the, like a car tire or a motorcycle tire, you're modeling it straight, and then you want to wrap it around into a circle and have the two edges join where they meet. Well, the connect object can help with that. So this is just one little example of how the connect object can sort of help you create sort of continuous geometry out of multiple parts. But if you have any other cool uses for this object, let me know. I'd love to know. And again, you know, thanks to Nick for sort of opening my eyes with this. I never realized that you could use the connect object to add to sort of morph the caps of type into the hulls of the type, like I showed you earlier on. So let me know what you think, and I'm looking forward to hearing some feedback on this format. See ya.